Oh boy. I guess I love thinking. I know that sounds very basic. I love witnessing and watching and reading and interacting and then thinking about all of those things. Sometimes it actually can be overwhelming. But I guess that's why teaching ended up being a really nice fit for me, because that sharing and bouncing off of ideas and sort of maybe seeing something in a way that I hadn't thought of before, those are the moments that really are most exciting to me.
My dream is to become a doctor. My mom, I think it was 2010, she passed away, she had cancer. It was a really devastating time because, I mean, at that time, I was only 10 years old too. I didn't really know what happened. I just knew my mom wasn't there anymore. But after that, I had like moved and I lived with my aunt for like 3 years. And then my other aunt who lived here in the U.S., she came and got me and another sister because of our age, we were like the youngest that she could get. So she got us. So I've been here since 2012. 7 years now, but 2016, I went back home because my dad had stroke and he passed away. They just didn't know what was wrong with him, but when we saw, like, my aunt saw a video of what was going on, she was like, this is what is wrong, this needs to be done, but the doctors didn't know what to do. Nigeria, so they were unable to get that help they needed. So that's the reason why I really want to go into the medical field, because I think I can go back and help out, at least not, if not my family, but other people that really need it.
The fact that like I have to be like, cause like I don't really have like a father figure like in my household, so like I feel like being like the man of the house like keeps me passionate about family and stuff, like, and knowing how like important it is. So like family's always gonna be there for you no matter what, and like they're like the number one thing in your life that you always have to like support and love. My mom does a lot, and like I just like help take off the load a lot because like my sisters work, my sisters play sports, and like during like the fall and winter, I was like the only one home, so like I had to help her, and she like had a lot of surgeries, so like I was always like changing her ice packs, like helping like change clothes and stuff, and like make food and stuff. So it's just like teaching me like real life to be like a man when I'm older for like my kids.
I'm a part of a lot of special needs clubs at Sandberg, so I do a lot with Special Olympics and our Friendship Connection. And so I wanted to work with special needs when I got out of college, but I didn't see myself as a special education teacher. So I was looking at majors and what I could like do with different majors, and neuroscience seemed like I could do a ton of different things, like research or an occupational therapist, or just a lot of things that I could make it work to work with people with special needs. So that was my plan. I just want to make everything more inclusive. Like, I'm a big advocate for like inclusion in all aspects of life. So like whether it be like minorities or different like disabilities or anything, I think everyone just deserves the same chance to get to know each other, and like everyone should be given the same opportunities, like no matter their abilities or like where they come from. So I hope to like bring that wherever I go.
I'm gonna be passionate with like football. I really love football. I like hanging out with people. It's like it's a group that I love being around with. We support each other. We just like being a family together. The people I'm around with, the coaches, Coach Berg, he motivates me. Sometimes I could be backed up in school and he'd always come up to me and be like, you gotta catch up with your work. It's like that with all the coaches. They make sure you're okay in school. They check up on you, and it just feels like a family when you're in that team. And I'm gonna try to become like a special ed teacher, like a one-on-one type of teacher. And then on the side, probably like do like a football coach or something like that.
Well, I went into teaching, which is not the most obvious career, for the fact that ever since I could talk, I stuttered. Thanks to years of therapy through St. Xavier's when I was little, I slowly began to control my stutter. You don't ever overcome it. You just learn to function with it. And oddly enough, teaching was still calling me despite the fact I spent years not talking in class. So I guess the big message that I like to share with teachers or anybody is that you never really know someone's story in terms of, I when you stutter, you don't look like you're gonna have a stutter. There's nothing different about me. It's just that my fluency is not where everybody else's is. So I wanted to go into the teaching profession knowing that if I noticed someone who had some type of speech fluency issue, that I would be there to help them understand that this is something that you can control and you can overcome this, and it should not define you. But it defined me for a very long time. So it's not that it was an easy path, but it was a path I still wanted to go on and to become a teacher.
It's just me and my mom, and she's a babysitter, so she doesn't make a lot of money. So I have, it was around freshman year that I had to like start working in like the nail industry, which I knew was like it was gonna that I had to do one day, but I didn't expect to be that soon. And I'm like kind of like the, I would say the man in the family, because I take care of bills, I make sure that everything's up to date. Like I fix everything if I could, make calls, and sometimes it's very hard because I'm dealing with school and like try and get scholarships and like try and get into college, and then having to go home and take care of those things. It gets very stressful. It's like I feel like all these challenges will help me later on in life, because I go through them, and yeah, it's very hard and stuff like that, but I think the experience I get out of it at the end, it's worth it.
Let's just start with, I came to this country 3 years ago, almost, and I came to stay 2 years ago because first I was in a school back in Chicago. Teachers are always like there to support you, to be like your parents, see if you eat lunch, if you are doing good in your classes, like everything. They just check on you, like if they were parents see you. So that's what I love in here, that they didn't have that. Like we didn't have those kind of teachers in my country, or back in Chicago, the teachers were like, if you don't want to learn, you don't learn, it's not my problem, we don't care. But in here, they care so much about you, and it's so nice to feel like you're special in here.
I always feel like helping others is really what I was meant to do. This came to me when I was young. My parents, we immigrated here when I was 5 years old. We were the second family in Burbank at Maddock Elementary School, and we didn't have anybody that can help us with language. So they were kind enough to get us a tutor, but the tutor spoke Spanish. So in their way of trying to help, they've got someone, but not somebody that was able to help us as a family. And feeling that way, I remember being in first grade and feeling the way that I did. I said, I really don't want anybody else to feel like this, and I'm gonna do something about it, which is so bizarre being that young, but I did. I knew then that I wanted to be a teacher and an educator, and that's really the passion that drives what I do today.